Hi everyone, this is Thomas Hoff speaking from the product management team here at Qlik, and welcome back to my series of presentations within the area of content workflow. Today I will talk about a new data consumer role that we are going to introduce here to our Qlik Sense Enterprise SaaS environment. And this will allow users to only consume data. It is possible to be used in shared and managed spaces. So we have changed and adjusted the UI like a little bit. As you can see it on the left-hand side, where I show you the shared space, is this new can consume data role, which is actually the data consumer role. And the same one exists on the right-hand side, other screenshot here within the managed space, right? Meaning you can then multi-select roles as well in a shared space as you can multi-select roles in a managed space and, so to speak, assigning permissions on a more fine-grained level to users. And in particular, the can consume data role is important because previously, or like before this role becomes like available here, the only way for you to give someone read access to a data file or data connections is by giving them can edit, right? So this is a bit too much, and that's what we said. You know, I don't want everyone that can technically read the data, I don't want everyone to as well be able to change, to lead, and to edit my data connections. I want like a role that only gives people access to consuming it as a developer in a different space, but not necessarily changing and, again, deleting data files or doing anything else with it, right? So that's why we introduced this role. And so let me go into the actual demo. So on the left-hand side, I'm logged in as a tenant admin on my tenants here. And on the right-hand side, I'm using a different user. So just to show you what's actually available. So the first thing I show you, like the list of my spaces, and I have a few that I created with my trigram to start, you know, and I do have this new one, the THP one dev sandbox, and in that space I want this user on the right hand side to actually develop apps, and I do have data files within this the shared space that I'm in right now, which is the development one, right? So when I'm looking into this one first, I go to my data sources. So I do have like a couple of data files here, and there's like one data connection, right? And when I'm going to members, I do see that this user on the right hand side has two roles assigned to him. And one is can view and the other one is can consume data, right? So that is what I'm defining here. And then to show you that this works the other way around, you know, that if I have another space and I'm using this validation here as an example, right? So I can go to my data sources and there's like a copy country geo QBD in that one, right? And in this particular space, so this user, when I'm going back to members here, so this THP user can only view, right? So there's only like for him the ability to view content in the space, but this user should not be able to see any data connections or any data files, right? So now let me go actually into this view from the user that should now develop content for me in this other space. I'm going to my sandbox environment here. And here within that one, I will ask him to create a new analytics app, right? And I'm calling it my new app, and I'm creating it right in this sandbox environment here, and I will open the app right away. So there it is, and then I will go into the script editor to show you that immediate behavior. So when I'm going to the script editor, what I will see here on the right hand side is, like, of course I have like access to this dev sandbox here because I'm like an editor in that space, so meaning I have access to everything. Then I do have my personal space, and then only I can see my development environment where I can see like the data files and this like one and only available data connection, right? So this is really where I'm empowering this user to see data that's coming from specific spaces, but I do not want this user to be like an editor, or like in other words, to be a developer in the space. So that again makes it like much more granular. So you can set up and you can define the security settings that you want to use here on a more fine-grained level by using this role and making developers, or like enabling developers, to only consume data out of different spaces, but not like doing anything else. It's really like giving them the permissions they need, but not more than this. So I hope this demo was useful here, and thanks for listening in, and talk to you next time. Bye for now.